Time now for the Dunkin NHL comeback, and the Pittsburgh Penguins coming back from an early 2-0 deficit to score 5 unanswered goals against the Rangers and hold on to that 5-2 score. Barry, you were saying that Pittsburgh Penguins kind of laying in the weeds a little bit going into the postseason?
Mike and I were talking about that this morning, that you don't hear about Pittsburgh. It's like they're non-existent. Everyone's talking about Winnipeg. Everyone's talking about Nashville. Everyone's talking about Tampa Bay. Everyone's talking about other teams. No one's talking about the team that Sidney Crosby plays for, Malkin plays for. So they're just quietly playing very well. They're quietly, you know, nestled softly in a playoff position. And they're one of those teams that you don't want to play in the first round if you're an upper-tier team. So Winnipeg looks, or the rumor of their demise, I think, is grossly overstated.
Yeah. And Matt Murray's got his game back, which looks is good. Key. And all of a sudden now,
Schultz is back.
Looks tied up with the Islanders. We may get Washington, Pittsburgh in the first round. Who knows how this shakes out? But we were watching this game early on, and they got it 2-0. Like, this game's not over.
No.
Because you look at the rosters, the importance of it to Pittsburgh, and even without Letang and some of the other big stars, they got a lot of contributions from their depth player. Bluger with a couple, Bjugstad with one. You didn't see Crosby all over this highlight reel, and that's important for Pittsburgh. Occasionally, it can't be Sid every single time. Can't be Gensel every single time. Other guys have to step in there. They did in this one.
Other night, Boston Bruin, they weren't getting any offense from the guys like Bergeron, guys like that. Corrali got two. Mm-hmm. Heinen got one, things like that. So the good teams this time of year, you got to get that secondary scoring from guys that you don't normally count on because the other team is spending so much energy stopping them that you get against this 5 and 6 defenseman. You get against fourth line. You got to bury them when that happens.
You mentioned secondary scoring. Generally, what other elements do you like to see from a team at this time of year?
I like to see defense tighten up. I like to see guys get better in their own zone. Obviously, goaltending, but that's a simple answer. Yeah. Everyone knows you got to have great goaltending. But, you know, I think offense is certainly there during the regular season. I want to see teams get really good defensively. No two-on-ones, no three-on-twos against, things like that.
God, you sound like a coach. Unbelievable.
What about you, Johnny? What are you concerned about?
Because that's the right answer.
At this time of the year,
there you go. At this time of year, that's what Mike Sullivan's begging for as well. He wants his team to tighten up because for a lot of this year, they've scored their way out of trouble and they get a little loose in their own end. They don't pay that much attention to detail because they have the talent to score their way out of bad situations. Down the stretch, into the playoffs, that's more difficult to do. So Mike Sullivan is going to echo exactly what Barry just said.
That's why Dallas
system
is,
tightness. And that's Dallas why Dallas is scary.
Team because they're a very good defense.
They're not going to give you much. Nope. You're going to beat them. It's going to be 2-1. It's going to be 3-2. They're not going to give you anything
thing.
For free.
I under same thing.
And if your goalie's playing well, as Murray and Ben Bishop are, it's a tough out.
Unless I'm looking at their schedule incorrectly, I think they're off until Friday, the Pittsburgh Penguins.
The Pittsburgh Penguins are, in fact, yes.
Okay.
Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Yeah, they play Nashville.
They'll be at home against the Predators.
We got to go to paper. We got to gas the computer, and we got to go to paper.
Right here in front of me. Nashville on Friday.
Nothing wrong with keeping it.
And you know what, though?
20th century.
1850s.
With Malkin nicked up, with Letang hurt, 3-4 days off this time of year. Is almost unheard of, and they'll take a couple of them and do almost just about nothing.
Well, the teams that are in the playoffs now will start resting those guys anyway, so that's what's another thing to look for with your team.
Load management.
Who's going to play the rest of the year, things like that.
Dunkin NHL comebacks are presented by Dunkin. Where there's hockey, there's Dunkin. America runs on Dunkin.